Hello everyone, welcome to the final race already of our Winter is Coming Championship. I can't believe how quick these always fly around each time. So round five, final round, and double points tonight for people. So plenty of action coming up. Charlotte, how are you doing?
Yeah, all good. Can't believe it's the last round already. It's come around pretty quick. I actually thought we had another two more to go. So don't know what planet I've been living on over the last week or so. But yeah, looking forward to it. It's going to be very, very close. We know it's like a handful of points that is going to be the deciding factor between the top three. So yeah, we'll see what happens.
Hello then everyone, welcome to race night at Silverstone for the final round of Winter is Coming Championship. It's Miles Hemming on pole then for that monster energy machine on the McLaren there. So great start to his campaign for his final round of the championship. Matt Mitchell returns with a P2 on the front row of the grid. Bjorkman also for Spearhead Race Engineering alongside Mitchell for P3, Dominic Stallman for P4. So we've got all of the key players in tonight's championship inside the top five. Let's strap in then, folks, because it is about that time to go racing for the last time of this championship. Last 3 months now, it's going to boil down to this next 90 minutes and we are off. So looks like Hemming's got away nice and cleanly. Stallman's going to have to try and hang it around the outside of Bjorkman, who also gets a good start. Is Mitchell going to let his teammate come through, or is Mitchell going to be fighting for position tonight? But currently, he's tucking into P2 at the moment. So let's see what happens on that one. So the top four all getting away nice and cleanly. I'm not seeing any yellow flags appearing anywhere on the map at the moment. So that's a good sign for our stewards in the background. But so far then, Hemming gets away well. Is Mitchell going to be close enough to make the most of the slipstream on the opening lap? Not quite sure. Chrissy Palmer is now breathing down the neck of Max as well. We have to see if he can do it, but I think Chrissy might go for the inside
Chris
here.
Chris is going
to
go for the lunge here.
Yeah. And actually, we see Max clip the... Oh, I thought he was going to rejoin into the side of Chrissy there. Max caught the back end of Akbulut on the exit of that corner there, didn't he? And actually, Akbulut had that happen to him at Imola. It was Bjorkman that spun him around that time. So the stewards have the luxury of getting onto that replay and watching that back, but... I wouldn't hold your breath for there not to be a penalty on that one, but it is a close call regardless. I only saw a snippet of it. So let's see, everyone. Tell us what you think. So it looks like Max has got a 15-second penalty for that issue at, incident with Akbulut earlier on. I mean, you could easily argue he's lucky he didn't get more there because Akbulut has gone way down the order.
Max is doing pretty well, isn't he? So, okay, so he's P19 at the moment. He qualified down at like P26 or something. So he's made his way up the grid really, really nicely. It looks like he's on a little bit of his own space at the moment, though, from what we can see on our side of things.
But yeah, yeah. Well, we can check it out in a second. Actually, that was Balestros, Sandro Balestros going through. I believe Sandro either just has or is about to go and do some racing at Silverstone in the real world. He's just moved up from karting to car racing fairly recently. So a bit of extra practice on the sim going around the track. And actually, all the R&D boys. Oh, as Davenport just loses the back end of that Merc on the switch of direction there and just basically spoons himself off in the wrong direction. That was quite an unusual place for a car to go off, actually. I think he must have just got on the power a bit too hard coming out of Brooklands and, yeah, just lost the rear end. Oh, big slide for Max Spooner there. And actually, he has a bit of fishtailing going on in that Lamborghini as well. Somehow manages to keep it pointing in the right direction and is able to stay in the race, but... That is not a place you want your car to be trying to swap ends with you. The whole way through, we've got battles going on. As Liam, nearly. He said to me beforehand when we was clarifying the ruling on penalties, he said, well, I'm going to be getting loads of 15-second penalties now. I was like, well, you won't if you don't hit anyone, Liam. And he nearly lived up to that then. But luckily, he didn't. And Hank Lancaster lives to see another day. Yeah, it's just going to be... tea time with Liam about halfway through the endurance race on Sunday. So if you're wondering what to do before and after Formula One, and maybe even on in the background during Formula One, as he makes a move.
I was going to say.
Sorry.
That was nearly double move. So he's just made a great move on Lancaster there. She thought he was going to go for the Thoros as well at that point. But he just dropped back a little bit as he goes into Stowe, but quite racy.
It's not a bad time for a shameless plug, to be fair. If people are sat there watching this and you're not following us on Instagram or TikTok or Facebook or Twitter or any of the above, it would be greatly appreciated if you could helps with all the work that goes into these, not just for Charlotte and I, but George and George of all the media. Harry with getting clips and pictures and helping with the shooting side of it. There's loads going on. As Dom Stallman and Andrew's come together, we're just looking on a different camera feed there, but I just saw that in the corner. I didn't see that, did you? That's going to be one for a replay in the stewards. Even more reason to follow us, because we can get those replays put out on socials.
As Heath now takes full advantage of that and comes through, and then I think that's Andelson, sorry, who comes off in the background, but all of a sudden there's now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 car pack, of which actually Heath is going to be ultimately the winner out of that one. So fair play to Heath. He's now jumped up to P6 from starting P13. So awesome, awesome drive from him so far. And yeah, Stallman comes into the pit, so he's going to take...
Comment that on a second, because I think that was a pretty good move. So as we just digest that then, as I said, several cars all in battle at once, but Kirk Heath jumping up to P6 from, what was he, 8th or 9th? Before that, I think he's in 8th for 6th.
And there was a gap as well.
As you can see, Mr. Mitchell takes the lead, but remember, the little one in the orange box next to their car number means they have yet to pit. So that means the top five have not yet pitted, although Michael Curran has just darted in. You can see then Hemming's now onto the back of Winkler, and he's thinking about having a move then as they come down Wellington Straight. Is he going to make that stick? Let's see. Dom Stallman had a drive through, and they've ended up back on the same bit of tarmac together again, separated by literally a few tenths. Oh my, Max really trying to get around the outside, inside, any angle that he can. And he goes to the outside, then coming into Stowe. Let's see if he can make that stick, because it is slightly off camber as you get to about halfway round. And you then have to use again the runoff, but it keeps two wheels on the track just about. And then he's going to have the inside prevail coming into the chicane as Liam Sharman is up ahead. And Ronan Stallman has to bail out, and you see him appear in the rearview camera there. Nicely done then. We haven't enjoyed much on board here, have we? Oh, Hagenbaum clips the back of Andrews there. Is he going to let him come back through? Yes, he is. Hagenbaum backs off and lets Andrews retake that. But in the meantime, that's allowed Max Jachtenberg to get up into P5. That could have been so, so much worse. So pit window's closing. Everyone should have pitted by now at this point in the race. But if they haven't, they'll get a penalty. But I think, as far as I've seen, everyone's green. Let's have a look. Yes, they are. As our co-commentator, Poppy the dog, is now fully up and around again, after a bit of a nap there through the middle. She's basically like a glory fan. Oh, Andrews just literally rocketed off to the other side there. Manages to hold the car and get back on and hold position, but that was a very, very scary moment for him, for the Aspire Racing driver, as he goes door-to-door with Hagenbaum. Still then, two abreast as we come back out onto Brooklyn Straight. Is he going to be able to get through? Hagenbaum takes to the outside, onto the AstroTurf a little bit, and now it's a straight drag race down into Brooklands. Under the bridge, who is going to get it? Hagenbaum's got the inside line at the moment, and again they bang doors, and this time it's Hagenbaum that comes off worse, and Dominic Stallman goes through, doesn't get caught up too much, but he does clip him on the way through there. Oh, and just as we said that, Harry Melvin mentioned in our commentary chat, I think this might end in a penalty, and I'm not sure who's I'll call that, because they are both pretty level going into the corner, but They get the luxury of watching it back on slow-mo replays as many times as they need to look into this stuff. And that is for quite a high position. As we see then, Hagenbaum picks himself up a 15-second penalty for that incident. So Hemming's now in the back of Andrews. And so kind of teammate in a way then, if Andrews is admin of BOA Esports and Hemming races for them. I don't think he's going to put up much of a fight, and doesn't look like he's going to. They're going to Vail. Dom Storm is going to have to try and get through as well in that second in the BMW. And Andrew's not making it easy for him. That was some team play as well. So Stallman in that blue BMW is trying to get past, and you can see how easily Hemming with the black Monster Energy delivery McLaren got through. So definitely some team play.
He hasn't got blue flags being waved at him either, has he?
No, this is all for position.
Yeah.
I mean, these two have actually fought back up quite well, considering, haven't they? You know, Dom Stallman having a drive through, and he gets through then at the first hairpin. A little bit of a nudge of doors, elbows fully out, but gets through there without any major issue. So Dom's through, Hemming's through. And now we've got 2.5 minutes just over for Dom to try and make a final charge through. Well, here we go then. The Spearhead Race Engineering driver has had a very, very solid race as Liam Sharman kindly gets out of the way. And backs off well before the line. I was waiting for Sharm to take him out.
But I know, I was just like, oh.
Matt Mitchell wins the final round. Awesome drive then for the spearhead race engineering driver. Comes back with engines after that little break that he had, and won the first race and the last. So great effort by him. And then Rob Bjorkman, the other driver to win two races, comes in P2 and will be taking that championship crown then tonight. So great driving by the spearhead boys. Do you know what? I just realised that Engelhardt got recruited into spearhead race engineering as well. So that is spearhead 1, 2 and 3 as they proudly demonstrate now, flying through Maggots and Becketts. So Bjorkman will win the championship for the drivers, and spearhead will take it for the teams. So really, really nicely done. If we bring the timing screen up, just as we get some celebratory donuts in the background, then you can see who's where. But yeah, right, well, thank you everyone. I'm going to go ahead and wrap things up so I can get on the road. Thanks Ben, thanks Harry, thanks George, thanks Charlotte, thanks Poppy, and everyone that comes and takes part in chat. And we will see you on Sunday for our 6-hour race. Don't forget, you can enter if you can. Bye for now.